Ćao ljudi, My People Magazine, gledate intervju iz Doma omladine, nalazimo se tu sa Just Blaze-u koji će odgovoriti na par naših pitanja. Ništa je da ga ne bi zadržavali, krenut ćemo lagano. This is your second time in Serbia.
Yeah,
last summer you were at the Exit Festival. Did you think that you would come back to Serbia this soon?
Exit Festival, we had a good time, it went really well. So I figured I'd probably be back sooner than later.
Yeah, nice. How was the Exit Festival?
It was really good. I had a good time. Yeah. It was a really good crowd, good energy. So I liked it a lot.
You're mostly known for your work with like Jay-Z and some other big names in hip-hop. But like in the last few years, you kind of gravitate more towards like some electronic sounds and different styles. Like what was, let's say, not in a... like a full way, but what was like a turning point where you decided you want to explore like into those kinds of sounds and tracks?
It wasn't really a turning point. I mean, I've always made like electronic music. People just never really heard it. But like, I mean, even if you go back to like 2003, me and Joe Button did a record called Fire, which was a Jersey house rap record. Mm-hmm. You know, me and Rod Digga, the next year, we did a remake of Party and Bullshit, which was also kind of like a Jersey Chicago house record or a rap record based on those kind of sounds. I'm from New Jersey, so we've always there's always been like one foot in house music, one foot or club music, one foot in hip hop.
It was so, like a mix of
that's how I grew up. So for me, it wasn't really a transition or a change. It was more so now. The last few years have been a good time for me to expose that to the world. So it wasn't like I consciously said, let me make a change. It was more so like, oh, we can do this now. Because when I tried to do it before, I think I was a little too early. Mm-hmm. But I did it, you know, like 10
years. Like the scene wasn't really...
Exactly, it wasn't ready for that.
Yeah.
You know, like those records worked in certain places, like in Jersey, Chicago, Baltimore. You know, those records worked, but on a nationwide or worldwide level, the hip-hop scene just wasn't there yet.
Yeah, okay. Now I know like a lot of rappers like need the beat to write the verse. Some just like fit their verse to the beat.
Mm-hmm.
But you're the one that actually makes the music and the beat. And like where does your inspiration come from, and like how complicated is your like creative process?
I feel like the creative process should never be complicated. If it's overly complicated, then it's not spontaneous and it's not natural. I don't like to overthink it. Mm-hmm. You know, like for me it's like my best records have come about really just like hanging out, throwing some ideas out there, and just kind of, you know, going from there. I can get inspired by anything. You know, I think any of us who are truly creative already know that. It's like you could be inspired by something visual, you could be inspired by something you hear, something you read. You know, inspiration comes from so many places. There's really no set method as to how these records get made. It's all about what, you know, at the end of the day, we're taking something from here and putting it out to the world, you know what I mean? And that's really the only constant, is that it comes from something you feel here or something you feel here, and then you put it out to the world.
Tell me, like, if you would have, like, what are some new artists now, it doesn't matter if they're rappers or like producers / DJs, that you like and that you would like to work with today?
That's a tough one. I've worked with so many people, you know what I mean? I can't say that there's any one particular person that I want to work with at this point in my career. But some of the people that I like, in terms of rappers, you know, it's funny enough. I went to a Rich Homie Quan show last night because I had a show on a night off in Barcelona, and I ended up kicking it with him. And just, you know, we're obviously from two different worlds, two different generations, two different eras, but we had a lot of the same music sensibility, so we're talking about doing something together, which I think a lot of people would probably trip over if that actually happens, because they just wouldn't expect that, you know. But I kind of like that. At this point, those are the kind of things that I like doing.
Yeah, like surprising people.
Yeah, just like things that you would not expect. Like, you know, like when I did a hire with Bauer like 2 years ago, nobody expected that.
Yeah, that was a big surprise.
Yeah, and people were just like, huh? I don't even know what to think, but then it was so good.
You
couldn't hate on it. You know, and that's my thing. I just like to make good music.
Yeah. You know? And now tell me, like, when working with people like Jay-Z, T.I., Eminem, they're well-established artists, and that are really like in tune and know, like production-wise, how things work. Like, how complicated is working with them?
not, those are some of the easiest people to work with. They, you know, they, at the end of the day, you got one thing you have to keep in mind is, as much as they are seasoned artists and veteran artists, I'm a seasoned and veteran producer. So yeah, it's kind of like when you have that understanding, it's kind of just like, all right, you know, they do what they do, I do what I do. You know, we're both, you know, in most cases, we're both, you know, good at what we do, and we're in tune.
Yeah.
They when they come to me, they know what they're coming for. You know, when they come to me, I know what it is they want from me most of the time, you know? So it's just a matter of finding that common inspiration and then just going, you know? Most of my records with those guys, a lot of those big artists, have been some of the easiest ones I've ever made. Because we're both just, we both know what we want.
Yeah, nice. And last question, what can we expect from Just Blaze in the future? Do you have any plans for like a project, like an album or something like that?
I'm not making an album.
No?
No.
But that would be a good project.
Yeah, you know,
maybe. I personally would like to hear like Just Blaze on the production and a lot of big names on.
You know what it is? The game is a little bit different now. One thing that I've considered doing is taking a lot of the unreleased songs that I have, maybe putting those together as a package, you know, and putting that out to the world. But running around trying to get verses from rappers and putting all that together, it's not for me. Not at this point in my life. I'm not trying to chase anybody now for verses, you know. I think it would be cool to get a lot of the unreleased material that I have, because I have so much.
Yeah, I can bet.
Yeah, and you know, and maybe find a way to take those records and update them and put them out to the world. That could be fun. Because I think for me, it's just more so, I've been in so many different places in my career, just mentally, music-wise, and inspiration-wise. It might be cool to give listeners a glimpse to all the different places that I have been over the course of my career. Okay. You know? And then maybe one new record, who knows?
Yeah.
I mean, I'll think about it.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you a lot for this interview, man.
Anytime.
Yeah. Okay.